If not for this single tool called Notion, my life would be a mess, more than it already is. And that's absolutely no exaggeration. And by the end of this video, you'll understand why, because in this video, I'll give you a tour of my digital workspace in Notion and show you how I run my personal life and businesses with my team through Notion since 2019. I've mentioned Notion plenty on this channel and I've featured it in previous videos. So when the folks over at Notion slid into the DMs and asked me if I'd like to partner with them to bring you guys this tutorial you're watching right now, of course, I said yes. So thank you, Notion, for partnering with me on this video. And for those who are wondering, what the heck is Notion? Your life's about to change. So Notion is known as an all-in-one workspace. And one of the best things that I love about it is it's completely free to use initially. I didn't pay a single cent for probably the first 6 months using it. And it was more than enough to get my life organized. And so now at this point, as you can see on screen here, I've got three different accounts at the moment. So the first account is for personal use. Then I have another for the YouTube and the education company side of things. And then finally, another one for our e-commerce brand, which my business partner runs. If we jump on my screen here, it looks all complicated and whatnot. But honestly, I personally set up my space to be as simple as possible. There's a big difference between being organized and overly organized. That's something I want to stress to you. When you spend more time setting up and organizing Notion than you actually spend on the task itself or work itself, don't fall into that trap. All right, so jumping into my personal account here. So I've named it Andrew Headquarters for no particular reason. I just thought it was cool. Like, I've seen Justin C and he set up through his Notion tutorial on YouTube. He calls his Formula One and I find that really cool too. The great thing about it is you can set it up however way you like it. So I've got the headquarters page here. You can see absolutely everything. I even have a few widgets here that I find useful, like a couple time zones. These are time zones that I usually work with. You know, I've got a lot of clients over there. And then I've got the Sydney weather app. And these things you can implement actually through a website called AppNotion. So AppNotion.co is very useful. It's a very easy way to implement widget apps. So if we say, for example, this weather widget here, right? If you click on visit website, you get to customize the widget however way you like it, you know, colors, location, etc. Then click get code. Then you're going to copy this to the clipboard, go back into here, right? Click generate Notion embeddable URL down here, copy and paste into the HTML code right here, this box here. And then you're going to get this link here and go back into your page on Notion. And basically you're just gonna copy and paste it, like that's it. And then it'll auto update into this widget that you see here. It's so useful that you get to implement embeddable items like these into your space. So that's how I've set up these personal embeddable app Notion things here. How I like to lay out is have that home page where you have everything that you like to see. I think the first thing I'll show you is how I organize my day, my day-to-day life. So whenever a new week comes by, so on Sunday, I'll spend like 15 minutes just getting ready for the week. All I do is literally duplicate this template that I have, and then I customize it every single week to get ready for the week ahead. I very roughly structure my day so I know what's going on each day of the week. I even have habit trackers down here. You know, I'm currently playing the piano, so I want to spend 30 minutes playing the piano. I want to spend an hour in the gym every day. And that is my way of habit tracking. But then beyond that, it's very flexible as well. Like, I can delete things here. I can add items here as a to-do list. If you're wondering how would you get set up with this a template like this here, I highly recommend that you just use Notion templates. If you're starting with a completely new blank page, which you all will if you're new to Notion, type in page, right? Then click templates here. And there are so many amazing templates here. If you look at the task list here, right? You can see it's based very roughly on this weekly agenda, and I've updated it to suit my own needs and to spruce it up in terms like of appearance and whatnot. So my suggestion here is that you stick with the template to begin with and then build it out from there. I'll show you my reading list, for example. I believe I've just made this through a reading list template as well from memory, and then I've updated it. So what I've done here is I've actually integrated this list here with Goodreads. So whenever I want a new book or whenever I'm researching books, I can automatically pull it from Goodreads with the title, with the images, as you can see here. And I want to read a new book. I can just search it up here. Let's just type in Promised Land from Barack Obama. I basically use Google Chrome, a plugin with Notion. And if I click the Notion tab up here, I can add it to books to read, for instance, or books read archive. I'll go books to read and I click save page. What I do is I basically open it up in Notion and it will essentially update and appear in the list here. So as you can see, it's already in here. It usually pulls through with the author and the images and whatnot. Super useful tool to use. So all you need is the Google Chrome extension for this case. But yeah, I'll give you one more example. Cryptocurrency, for example, this is a very simple page where I keep up to date with all my cryptocurrency holdings and whatnot. These things here, this is actually a widget, not from AppNotion, but I found it through a guy called Aaron, free, absolutely free to use. And this you can pull automatically just by implementing the copy and pasting the URL link and implementing it, embedding it as a Notion widget within the page. So as you can see here, I'll link all this stuff down in the description box below. If anything's missing, just let me know in the comments below and I'll try to get to them. This is so useful because again, you get to customize it any way you want. And I have it set up so I have the trackers up here for very easy reading. And then my watch list, which I manually update, but I mainly go with a different app when it comes to tracking cryptocurrency. So this is not totally up to date. And then I have a whole bunch of notes at the bottom here when it comes to tracking cryptocurrencies and keeping up to date with cryptocurrencies. So that is how I've set my personal Notion up. It's honestly pretty straightforward. And my recommendation here is to stick with the templates when starting out because they're more than enough to get organized. Basically, I use mine to keep track of all my personal lists in my life, from books to investments to restaurants that I like. I basically treat it as a second brain. There's no way we can absolutely keep track of everything in our lives. So it's so satisfying to unload like all this brain clutter into Notion and then get organized from there. So the free personal plan is more than enough to achieve this. I'll leave a link under this video to get Notion free if you're interested. Now, when it comes to my businesses, it is a little different. I treat Notion as a collaboration tool and a place where we store all our systems and processes for the team. So if you run a business, you're planning to start a business, this segment is going to be pretty useful for you. So I'm going to jump back in, show you how I've set everything up with the YouTube side of things. And if you're enjoying this video so far, by the way, please do drop a like on this video and thanks for your support in advance. Getting stuck into the business side of things. So there is a bit of overlap between my personal and business life because it's kind of blurry when it comes to my personal and business life. But going back to the YouTube content, for example, I find this extremely useful. This is something I'm on all the time. It's a Kanban board. And if you don't know what that is essentially what you see on screen here. You move these little cards across the board when things are completed. So visual, so important to my day-to-day, and it has changed my life. We work with a lot of brands. We are fortunate enough to work with a lot of brands. And if I take a look at this one here, which we're scripting at the moment, which is about my tech everyday carry, what you can see here is I've created all these different cards to go with the main card. So if you have a team plan, you're able to assign this to different people on the team. So for example, if my video editor, his name's John, is able to edit this one, then I'll assign it to him and he can see the progress throughout the Kanban board. Then we move the status. This is automatically updated. If I move this across the board, the published date, is it sponsored, who is it sponsored by, who we're working with. And this part is a relational database, or actually a few of these parts. So you can see this arrow here shows that it's connected to a different database. And that's the beauty of Notion. You're able to connect it to different databases. So say, for example, this is updated with different sponsors, then we can see how many times we've featured a certain brand in certain videos. Or if it's related to Instagram, right here, it can remind us that, hey, you need to create an Instagram post as well to accompany this video. So these things are great tools to use. I won't get into relational databases in the roll-up strategy. That's a separate video in itself. If you're interested in that technique, just let me know down below though. And yeah, this visual Kanban board is a great team tool to use when you're collaborating with multiple people. So talking about collaboration, let's go into my different accounts here. So this is all to do with our education programs and also our YouTube channel. So I can't show you a whole load here because there's a lot of confidential stuff in each of these little tabs here. But what I will show you is how we overall structure our Notion for business. So when it comes to Notion for business, we basically essentially treat it as like a huge SOP list, so standard operating procedures. So when someone new comes on board, like a new team member, they'll come in here and they've got all the tools that they need, all the reading that they need to do to get up to speed really quickly. Beyond that, we also have the onboarding document. So if we click into this, we have an onboarding document here. It's essentially like a wiki within our business Notion, and you can click on any of these items here and it'll take you to a whole new page filled with a lot of information. So that just saves a lot of people in the team a lot of time, so they're not constantly being bombarded with new questions. I want to stress that you can achieve all of this simply through templates. So if we click /page, then click page, and then go into templates here, all right? You can go into marketing, you can go into product management, you can literally click roadmap and then start to build everything out. It's as simple as that. So with a roadmap, it'll give you everything you need to create roadmaps that's similar to a Kanban board right here. But the big part of it here is that it's a big collaboration board. And I think I wanna really highlight that, because when it comes to teams, it's all about collaboration. It's all about adding team members into your Notion. As part of that, you want to add members into these boards. If I click share on the top right-hand corner, you're able to basically click share and add people into this board and start adding them into these different allocations and these different little tabs here. So, and this is really simple to update. And whenever they're added into a specific task, they're going to get an update, they're gonna get a note, and they're gonna get updated to be told, okay, hey, this is a task that you need to do right now. So I think Notion is absolutely awesome for teams. We also use a tool called Zapier. So with Zapier, whenever they get updated, it gets pushed onto our Slack team messages, and they also get notified there. So that makes sure that everyone knows what their role is. You know, we don't need to micromanage. They get all the freedom that they need, but this is our Bible of truth, essentially, our book of truth. Everything goes through Notion. So that is essentially how we use Notion for teams and collaboration. This has been a long video so far, and if you got this far into the video, be sure to drop the code phrase Notion for life, and I'll go ahead and like your comment. And what I've shown you today is just the surface of Notion, and I'm a total Notion novice too. I'd say get started with the basics and find tutorials that suit your needs. There are plenty of great tutorials out there besides the one that you've watched today. And Notion is extremely customizable, and everyone's day-to-day needs will be completely different, but that's the beauty of Notion. It adapts with you and your life. You can get started with a free plan, I'll link below. And thanks again to the great folks at Notion for partnering with me on this video. If you have any questions about Notion or this video, drop them below and I'll try to get to as many comments as I can. Hope you enjoyed this video. Drop a like if you did, sub if you want more business, marketing, and tech content from me. And as always, thank you for watching.